Hello YouTube and welcome back to the channel. Today we are back in Microsoft Flight Simulator and we are going to be taking the fly-by-wire A320neo from Castella, Split, Croatia to Hamburg, Germany. This should be a pretty good flight. It's a very early morning here in Castella, so let's grab our cup of coffee and jump into the aircraft and get things configured for our flight. All right, we're in the flight deck of the fly-by-wire A320neo. First thing we need to do is go down to our EFB, give the screen a tap. We're gonna import our flight plan from SimBrief. So we have Castella to Hamburg. Okay, we'll go to our ground services, fuel, import our fuel from SimBrief. So it's saying 17,400 pounds of fuel. Let's double check our flight plan. Lock fuel in the flight plan, 17,351 pounds. So we're good there. Refuel time will be instant. Okay, aircraft is fueled. We'll go to our payload. Import from SimBrief. So we have 174 passengers on board today. Cargo 7,613 pounds and our zero fuel weight is 133,498 pounds. Zero fuel weight center of gravity is 32.73%. Boarding time fast. And we can go ahead and load the aircraft. All right. We will go down to preliminary cockpit preparation. So we'll go downstairs. Engine master switches are off. Engine mode switch is normal. Parking brake is on. Landing gear handle is down. Wiper switches are off. Battery 1 and 2 are off. Battery voltage is above 25.5 volts. We'll switch battery 1 and 2 on. We have external power available, so we'll connect that. We'll do our APU fire test. Get the audible tone. And we can start the APU. Turn up some lights here. Let me first turn on the dome light. All right, so we'll turn up the captain PFD and the ND. We'll turn up the upper and lower ECAM. Turn up the first officer ND and the PFD. Turn up the FCU brightness and the center pedestal. Turn up the floodlights. Go upstairs. Turn up the overhead. All right, that looks pretty good. Go downstairs, parking brake off, our accumulator pressure is in the green, we'll check our brake pressure, we have between 2,000 and 2,700 PSI brake pressure, set the parking brake, check our flight controls, so our flaps are retracted and matched. Spoilers are retracted and matched. Probe heat is set to auto. APU bleed on. Check our fuel. So So we have no fuel in our center tank. Upstairs, we will use our left tank pumps and our right tank pumps. Center tank pumps can remain off. Turn on the crew oxygen supply. Crossbleed is set to auto. Zone temperatures are good. Electric panel, no faults except Gen 1 and Gen 2. Ventilation, all lights off. Check for any previously cleared messages. Press and hold the recall button. No messages. Go to the doors page. Our oxygen pressure is above 1500 PSI. Hydraulics page. Hydraulic fluid levels are good. For the engine page, engine oil quantity is good. Go upstairs. We'll do a CVR test. So ground control on. Press and hold the CVR test button. Get the audible tone, switch it back. EVAC should be set to captain. ADIRS to nav, 1, 2, and 3. External lights set. So our strobe light can go auto. Wing lights can come on. Nav and logo lights can come on. Turn on the seatbelt signs. No smoking signs, and we'll arm the emergency exit lights. Check our cabin pressure, it should be auto. Go upstairs. So our pack flow today is going to be normal. Go to the electric page. Our battery charge current should be below 60 amps. We're gonna switch our center tank pumps to manual. We'll do engine fire tests. So engine one fire, audible tone and checklist. Engine two fire, audible tone and checklist. Audio switching is set to normal. Go downstairs. Transponder will set to auto. Press clear twice. We're not actually going to use ATC today, so I'll just throw a random code in here of 2543. Go up to our MCDU, select FMGC. So engine is the LEAP-1A26. We have our current active nav database. We'll go to init. All right, so we are going from LDSP to EDDH. There's no company route, so we'll hit return. All right, so our flight number is LH4212. Cost index is 26. Cruise altitude is flight level 380. See what our alternate is. Our alternate. EDDB. All right, we'll go to flight plan. Select our departure. So we are departing runway 05 on the Zeta 1W. The Zeta 1W. Insert that. Alright, so from Zeta, we're going direct to Simba. So our next waypoint would be Simba. Zeta says Simba. And then we're going direct to Rudno. And we're jumping on the M736. And we're taking that to Akosi. Okay, from Akosi, we're going direct to Abgus. Akosi, direct to Abgus. Okay, and then from Abgus, we're going direct to Durbo. And we're going to jump on the T902 to Rarup. Rarup. All right, now we'll go to our destination arrival. So we're coming in ILS runway 05. Our arrival is the RARA 5A, the RARU 5A. Approach via DH-257. Insert. Check our flight plan here. So we'll go to plan 20 nautical miles. And we're just going to step through it here and check for any discontinuities or backtracks. All right, that looks good. Check our rad nav here. So Zeta's in here at 108.6. All right, we'll go to initialization, page B. Enter in our zero fuel weight center of gravity. Our block fuel is 17.3. See, our alternate is 3.5. Final reserve is 3. Okay. Just opening SimSmart on my second display here. I'm going to calculate the takeoff performance here. So we're at LDSP. Runway 05, pulling the METAR. Runway conditions dry. Anti-ice off. Our takeoff weight. £150,400. CG is standard. Takeoff thrust, we'll use flex. All right, we'll go to the performance page. So we're gonna use flaps 1 for takeoff. Flex to temp is 62. Let's see what our transition altitude is. Transition altitude is 10,000 feet. All right, V1. 135 knots, rotate 136 knots, and V2 is 140 knots. All right, let's check our altimeter here. So air pressure is 30.03 inches. 30.03. Set our standby. 30.03. Okay. Flight directors are on. Nav display range, we'll go to arc, 20 nautical miles. Speed window is hashed. Departure runway heading. So runway 05 is heading 049. Clearance altitude. Let's see here. We'll just say 5,500 feet. Okay, 5,500 feet. Standby set. Anti-skid nose wheel steering is on. We'll go downstairs. Weather radar is off. Predictive wind shear is off. Decam page status normal. Pressure is auto. Throttles are at idle. Engine master switches are off. Engine mode is normal. Parking brakes on. Transponder is set. We'll lock the cockpit door. Check our fuel again. So we have 17,320 pounds of fuel on board. And our block fuel is 17,351, so we're pretty close. We'll go upstairs, turn our beacon light on, disconnect ground power. All right, we are ready for pushback. Call pushback helper. Got an invisible tug today. Release the parking brake. Right there should be good. Stop. Set the parking brake and release the tug. All right, we are ready for engine 2 start. So we'll go down. Engine master switch should be switched to ignition start. And our fuel cutoff lever on. EGTs are rising, N1 is rising. All right, engine 2 is available. Repeat the process for engine 1. EGTs are rising, N1 is rising. Alright, engine 1 is available. Go upstairs. So our Gen 1 and Gen 2 fault lights should be extinguished. APU bleed should come off. APU master switch off. We'll go downstairs, set our engine mode switch to normal. We're going to use flaps 1 for takeoff. Arm the ground spoilers. TCAS should be set to TARA. Predictive wind shear auto. And our weather radar on. Check our flight controls. Full left, neutral. Full right, neutral. Nose down, neutral. Nose up, neutral. Full left rudder, neutral. Full right rudder, neutral. Auto brakes to max in the event of a rejected takeoff. Nose wheel light should be set to taxi. And we can release the parking brake. Pretty short taxi today. All right, we'll hold short of the runway. We want to go upstairs, turn our landing lights on. Nose light to take off. Check our takeoff config. Need to chime the cabin. All right, everything is green. Turn right here. get this big aircraft to turn. Get centered on the runway. All right. So we're going to bring the throttle to about 50%. Check for stability. 50% stable. Okay. We'll go to flex. 3 degrees nose down till 80 knots. Autopilot. Reduce the throttle to climb. Speed 185 knots. When we cross SP 800, we need to be between 4,000 and 5,500 feet at 185 knots max. All right, 5,500 feet, 185 knots. Let's climb up to 10,000 feet. We can accelerate to 250. Flaps coming up. Disarm the ground spoilers. Beautiful departure. approach 10,000 feet. We can turn our landing lights off. Nose light off. And we'll transition to standard. Alright, let's climb up to flight level 230. Managed. And we can accelerate to 290 knots. Across 14,000 feet. We're maintaining 290 knots. Just approaching 20,000 feet. right, we've approached 23,000 feet. I think we'll just climb up to our cruise altitude now. Flight level 380. Managed. While we're climbing to our cruise altitude, let's check our arrival procedure. So it looks like we have a few altitude and speed constraints along the arrival. So at Rarup, we need to be between flight level 110 and 4,000 feet. So I think we'll target flight level 110 at Rarup. We'll go down to our EFB, and we're gonna pull up our performance calculator. So we'll be at 38,000 feet, and we want to get down to 11,000 feet. 3-degree flight path angle, so we need to begin our descent about 85 nautical miles before target. Down to our MCDU. Rarup. Get Rarup. So we're 606 nautical miles away from Rarup. Need to watch our speed too. Once we hit Mach 0.78, we'll do the remainder of our climb at Mach 0.78, and we're also going to cruise at Mach 0.78. Everything's running pretty good so far. Nice, smooth climb out. just crossed 30,000 feet. Alright, there's Mach 0.78. Just approaching 33,000 feet. Alright, so I think I'm going to go into time lapse here. So when we're about 85 nautical miles from Rarup, we will begin our descent. So I'll go into time lapse and see you guys in a few minutes. We'll be right back. All right, we are about 95 nautical miles from Rarup. We want to cross Rarup at 11,000 feet, so I'm going to set that as our target altitude. 11,000 feet set. And we can begin our descent now. So I'll engage vertical speed mode. We'll start at 2,000 feet per minute. And I want to get this bottom of descent marker right on Rara. We'll start at 2,000 feet per minute. We can adjust it as we descend. We can enter in our destination data. So, Hamburg, altimeter is 3027. We'll go to performance, next page. 3027. Temperature is 22 degrees Celsius. Winds 140 at 6 knots. Transition altitude. Feet. Minimums. Feet. Landing config is full. Descending at 2,000 feet per minute. Should get us pretty close to 11,000 feet at Rarup. Might drop it down to 1,900 feet per minute. just crossed 30,000 feet. We've switched from Mach to speed, or knots, 290 knots indicated. We'll maintain 290 knots until we get to 10,000 feet, where we need to be at or below 250 knots. just crossed 20,000 feet. Pretty smooth descent so far. We need to start watching our speed because we got to be below 250 knots when we cross 10,000 feet. Alright, I'm going to start reducing my speed to 250 knots. Throw a little speed brake out. Alright, so we should be crossing Rarup at about 11,000 feet, and we need to get down to 4,000 feet at DH-231. So I'm going to set 4,000 feet as our next altitude. We'll adjust our vertical speed to 500 knots. 500 feet per minute. Transition altitude is 5,000 feet. Knots. need to be at 220 knots when we cross DH-230. We're under 10,000 feet, so we need to turn our landing lights on. Nose wheel light to take off. All right, start reducing our speed to 220 knots. Got some speed brake out. Cross DH-230 above 4,000 feet at 220 knots. Check our ILS frequency. So Radnav 110.5. 110.5, that's correct. Very slow descent. Just crossed 7,000 feet. When we are approximately 25 to 20 nautical miles from our destination, we'll activate the landing system. All right, we can activate the landing system now. We're about 20 nautical miles out. I'll reduce the speed to 200 knots. Turn the localizer on. Okay, we need a transition to 3027 inches. Set. We've acquired the localizer. See the glide slope diamond coming in? Okay, we'll reduce the speed to 200 knots. We're going to use low auto brakes today. That diamond gets close to the center, we'll activate approach. And 10 nautical miles away, we'll reduce the speed to 180 knots and we'll go flaps one. Activate approach. We've acquired the glide slope. About 10 nautical miles away, so we'll reduce the speed to 180 knots and we'll go flaps one. Drop the landing gear. Scrub off speed when they drop the landing gear. About 6 to 7 nautical miles out, we'll go flaps 260 knots.
2,500.
160 knots. Flaps two. Let's see what our approach speed is. Knots. 5 nautical miles out, we'll set our speed to 133 knots and we'll go flaps 3. Okay, 133 knots. Flaps 3. And full flaps. Check our missed approach. We'll climb to 4,000. Chime the cabin. We are fully configured.
Above. Minimum.
100. Disengage the autopilot. Approach. Disengage the auto brakes. And we will exit right. Completely clear the active runway. Should be good right here. Set the parking brake. All right, so we want to go flaps up. Okay. Disarm the ground spoilers. Turn the landing system off. Landing lights can come off. Nose light to taxi. APU can come on. Go downstairs. The TCAS will set to standby. Weather radar off, predictive wind shear off. All right, we are cleaned up. All right, let's see where we need a taxi. Quest taxi to the gate. just assume we got ATC clearance. Stop right here. We'll turn off our taxi light. Set parking brake. Go downstairs. Set our transponder to standby. Go upstairs. Set our APU bleed on. Fuel switches can come off. Upstairs. External power is available, so we'll connect that. Turn the APU bleed off. APU master switch off. Fuel pumps off. Beacon light can come off. Seat belts off. Cockpit door go normal. We can connect the jet bridge. All right, our jet bridge is connected. We are in a turnaround state. That was a pretty good flight. We made it here successfully to Hamburg. Really nice flight. I look forward to making more of these videos. If you guys have any suggestions for future flights, please leave a comment. I'd love to hear your feedback. Until the next one, we'll catch you later.